Hi guys, we are back again, Chaley. So today is the 12th of October 2021, and since last week I've been getting a lot of questions on Stella, I want to come to Ghana, and so I'm fully aware that a lot of you have plans of coming to Ghana this December for Christmas, because Ghana is now the hub of Christmas party, Christmas destination, and so a lot of you, I'm sure you are planning your trip here. So you may want to watch this video before preparing to come to Ghana this Christmas. So let's go right into the video. This is going to be me driving to work while having a conversation with you. So if you see me looking straight, just know I'm concentrating on the road. So yeah, so before coming to Ghana, you need to be fully aware of our COVID protocols before coming to Ghana. And so you need to take your COVID test 3 days before the trip, and also be ready to also pay $50 if you're a Ghanaian when you arrive in Ghana for COVID test, and $150 if you are not a Ghanaian, if you are not a Ghanaian passport holder. So once you get into the country Ghana, you have to be you have to know that there's going to be a long queue because of the COVID protocol, so you need to be patient with us. So after the COVID test, if you are positive, you'll be quarantined for some days under your cost. It will be your own cost. So before leaving the airport, you need some information of where you're staying. So if you don't have anywhere to stay, you can book an Airbnb, you can also book a hotel, guest house, lodges. Guest house and lodges are a little below hotels, so that's like a two-star, one-star kind of accommodation. And so you need to know your address of where you're staying, because they'll need that at the airport before you set up. Once you arrive in Ghana, you can opt for, if you don't have a family member picking you, you can opt for Uber, Bolt, Yango, which are apps that we use. They are transportation apps you can use. There's also the airport taxis that you can also use. I will encourage you to use only the airport taxis, not the regular taxis you see around. So if for safety reason, just download Uber, Bolt or Yango. Those are the apps you can use. And also note that Ghana is still cash, it's still a cash country, so you would want to have physical cash on you. You can have like dollars, come and change it. You can change just a little at the airport, that is if you need to pay for your Uber also takes card, but I mean there are certain times your card might fail you, so you want to have physical cash on you. In terms of hospitality of Ghanaians, just know that Ghana is a very safe country. You can come here and feel free to walk about, do anything you want. You can wear skimpy clothes and no one would like question you. The only thing is people are going to watch. And so in terms of safety, Ghana is very, very safe. And I mean, I miss the fact that you need to be very careful with your surroundings. Ghanaians are nice people. You will notice right from the airport to sitting in the public transport to sitting in the Uber, Ghanaians are nice people. They like to engage you in a conversation. And if you come to Ghana and you need any information, just ask any local. I mean, be careful who you ask, but obviously make sure you ask questions, because that's the only way you won't get lost. You'll be comfortable with things. What to expect in December when you come? Currently we're in October, but it's kind of raining. I don't know why it's raining today. We are not in a rainy season, but it's been raining. But expect that the weather is going to be a little colder during December. Not too cold. Like when I say cold, so we usually have Harmattan during the December period, and Harmattan is a little dry and a little foggy. So if you live in like let's say Ebri, the eastern region, you tend to see a lot of fog around because of the weather, and it's a little dry, it's a little cloudy, a little. So yeah, that's the nature of the weather during the Christmas, the festive season. When you come, you can use in terms of transportation, we have Chotro, that's the bus, it's locally called Chotro. You can use regular taxis, you can use Uber, Yango, Bolt. You can also use motorbikes. But I would not recommend motorbikes for you as a foreigner coming to the country. If you know your way around, you can use motorbikes. Motorbikes because you want to get to your destination quickly. And can you note that because December, we have a lot of people coming in into our country, there's traffic. And so you'd want to leave the house very early in the morning or leave the house at specific times. So usually what I have noticed during December period is when you have stuff to do in town, leave very early from 6, 7, 8. After 8, that's like rush hour. People are going here and there. So then there is a little bit of traffic at a time. Then during the day, after lunch, that's 12. After 2, 3, 4, the traffic is also okay. There's no traffic. Then rush hour again after 5, 6, 7 is also a time that you'll be seeing a lot of traffic. And so if you want to avoid being stuck in traffic, then you need to leave the house early and come back as early as possible. So yeah, that's the situation with what happens in December during Christmas. Everybody owns a car, like automatically you see everybody having a car in Christmas, like so yeah, basically that's it in terms of traffic.
Also with the traffic bit, so you'd want to stay somewhere not too far from the airport. So because almost everything happens around Osu, Cantonment, East Legon, neighboring areas like Asaliboche, airport itself, airport residential, Jowulu. So if you want to avoid this traffic, you want to probably stay around those vicinities so you don't get stuck. Like someone who stays at, let's say, Kaswa is a little out of town, and so you would possibly be in traffic if you live far. So you'd want to choose these areas closer to the airport so that you wouldn't be stuck in traffic. So nightlife in Ghana is epic during Christmas. In fact, during the whole of December, nightlife is like the must-do thing. So while you are here, you want to take opportunity to go to Osu. There are a lot of restaurants. If you want me to recommend a lot of restaurants and pubs for you, let me know in the comment section. I can do another video for that. And so you want to take opportunity to visit all these places and experience Ghana life. And also, let's talk about food. Food is part of our culture. So while you are here, you want to try our local food. You want to try wache. You want to try banku fish and okro. You want to try fufu with soup. You want to try beans and plantain. I know a lot of you, especially the diaspora, people from the diaspora, like kelewele, is locally called kelewele. That's fried plantain with spices. And also note that we like pepper. So if you want your food mild, you could just request and tell them that, oh, you don't want a lot of pepper, because we Ghanaians, in fact, we West Africans, we like pepper. So most of our food are like very spicy. And so you would also want to try our local snacks, plantain chips, cocoyam chips. You want to try what's it called, asana. The food, you will really have to try it. I also have a video on cost of food on my YouTube channel. I'll share the link here. So if you want an in-depth details of how much food costs, I think you should go watch this video. And so yeah, in terms of food, is relative. If you want local foods, I mean, in your area, in your vicinity, you definitely find a local food, local beverage, like for breakfast, lunch. So you should try our local food. Please try our local food before you leave the country. You can download SendWave, WorldRemit. There are other apps you can download, so you could transfer money from your account to probably mobile money. When you come, try and get a local SIM card. You can get MTN, Vodafone, Airtel, Tigo. Yes, so any of these brands are actually good. So you can transfer money from you register the SIM with your passport, because yeah, with an ID card, but preferably your passport if you are not a Ghanaian. Then you can have mobile money. Mobile money is used, like mobile money is just like an app mobile money is like money on your phone. So you can transfer money from your account right to mobile money. So if you're going to be here for a very long time, I encourage you to register your SIM card, get mobile money, And so if you don't have cash on you, you can use mobile money to pay any services, like anything. You can pay anything. Most people take mobile money, even in the marketplace now, people take mobile money. So you don't want to find yourself stranded. You should get mobile money. Yeah, mobile money, both Vodafone, MTN, any network, any network of your choice, actually. So these are some of the items I think you should also remember to pack before coming. Number one is sunscreen, because it gets very hot here in Ghana, especially in Accra. You should also carry your allergic medication, that if you're allergic to anything, those citrulline and all the allergic drugs that you take, make sure, don't forget to take them. And also buy a mosquito repellent before coming here, or your malaria drugs, because we have mosquitoes here, so you don't want to leave Ghana with malaria. So you'd also want to carry this. These are the major things. The others are things you can easily get here. So while in Ghana, try and visit at least some of our tourist destination places. I mean, you all know I'm into travel. I like to see new places. And so while here, take opportunity to see something new, at least visit the Cape Coast Castle, Kakum National Park. And then if you're going to stay here for a long time and you want to go to the north, December is the perfect time to see the Mole National Park, where you can see the elephants, you can see the deers, you can see the wildlife, monkeys. It's the perfect time to see, because the weather is clear, and it's also the perfect time to see hippopotamus at Ventral Hippopotamus Sanctuary, which I will be seeing myself. And so yeah, I'm looking forward to that, because December is the dry season there at the north, and so you get to see the animals very well. And so that's it. And you also want to see the waterfalls. You want to see Blue Waterfalls. You also want to see Kintampo Waterfalls. You also want to go to Cape Three Points, the Western Region, that has the best view of the ocean, the Atlantic Ocean. You also want to go to Axim, have a good time. There are a lot of resorts. You can go through my channel. I've visited a lot of resorts. So you want to find yourself in one cool, calm, serene resort. Enjoy your time while in Ghana. You want to make your experience an exciting one and good experience, and so you want to take opportunity to visit all these tourist attraction places. I mean, there are a lot of other options. Oh, visit my channel. I have a whole list. If you also want me to also do a breakdown of where you must see, let me know in the comment section, and I'll definitely do that for you. And so try and make it an exciting one while here. Make a new friend, speak to a local, and it's easy to speak to someone here. It's very easy to make a new friend here, and so you want to make friends here so that they can hook you up to all the things that are happening here. And so yeah, when you come here, please don't be stuck up. Make new friends, because people are very friendly. People here are very friendly. And so yeah, also just know that in Ghana, almost everything is negotiable, except for maybe the things in the mall and other places. But if you go to the market, everything is negotiable. If they say something is 10 cedis, you can negotiate and say, oh, I have 8 cedis, I can pay 8 cedis, I can pay 5 cedis for this. And I mean, it's negotiable. So it's always better to even have a local with you. If not, you can still negotiate. I mean, if they are ready to sell, it's fine. If not, then you go your way. And also, most of the times in December, prices tend to be high. There's a hike in prices, and so expect that things are going to be slightly expensive than you experienced probably last year or a year before. It's always like that, and there are a lot of promotions in Ghana during the festive season. So you want to take opportunity to buy stuff for your family, for friends here while in Ghana, because things are like, people run a lot of discounts here. And so yeah, you want to take opportunity of that festive season to buy all the things you want to buy.
Yeah, in a nutshell, Ghana is a safe country, and we can't wait to have you here in Ghana. Ghana is very safe. Our people are nice. One more thing is, the lifestyle in Ghana is relative. It differs from what you are doing. And so if you are here on a budget, you know how to go about things. If you are here to spend, then obviously
So lifestyle is relative. Let me know in the comment section if you want me to also give you an idea of a full lifestyle and cost of lifestyle in Ghana. I did a cost of food in Ghana, and so you have an idea. But cost of lifestyle is relative. If you want to go to a bougie restaurant, expect to pay more. If you want to go to a regular restaurant, you obviously pay an average. If you want to go local, you obviously pay less. And so it depends on your choice and what you can afford. So yeah, I hope to see you in Ghana. Let me know if this video is also has also been helpful to you, and if there are any questions, kindly let me know in the comment section, and I'll definitely put up a video for that. If it's if it also required answers, I will definitely respond. Until next time on my next video, I'm super happy you are watching this video with me till the end. Thank you so much for the love and support, and see you in my next video. I post Wednesdays and Sundays, and so see you on Sunday. I love you all as always. Mwah.